Hi, I'm Eunkyung. For this week's online art club, we'll be looking at portraits in the Palmer's collection. A portrait is a type of artwork that represents a person, usually a specific person, and often attempts to reveal some aspect of the person's identity, experience, or personality in addition to their physical appearance. There are a lot of unique portrait pieces that can inspire us in the Palmer's collection. Some of the earliest portraits in the museum collection are on ancient bronze coins, such as this one that depicts Agrippa II, who was the eighth and final ruler of Judea. This coin was made in the middle of the first century, almost 2,000 years ago. Because portraits have been a popular subject for art throughout history and across the world, we can find many more examples to help inspire us. Some portraits emphasize the appearance of the person being portrayed by providing a lot of visual details for the face, body, and clothing while simplifying the background elements. Other portraits, such as these two self-portraits by notable artists, show a person surrounded by objects in their everyday environment. The furniture, setting, and objects nearby provide additional clues to the person's character or reveals things that are important to them. And sometimes the artist includes the surrounding environment and objects to create interesting and complex visual elements, as in these two photographs. Although the image of the child is fairly simple, notice how the evenly spaced horizontal lines on the wall behind him add an interesting contrast to his dark sweater while accentuating the stripes on his shirt. And the photograph of the mechanic becomes a powerful portrait of work and industry, with the imposing machine creating a circular frame behind and around him. Modern and contemporary artists sometimes experiment with the style of representation or the elements of art in order to communicate ideas about the person pictured, as well as to create interesting visual images. Artists find innovative ways to use line, shape, color, texture, and value to present a portrait that conveys energy, mood, and characteristics of the person without additional objects or background settings. And finally, some portraits don't even show a picture of a person at all. Instead, the artist presents other objects that are meant to act as symbols of ideas or personality traits that are important to the person portrayed. Did any of these portraits catch your attention and spark inspiration? Who will be pictured in your portrait? You or someone else? Deciding what kind of portrait you would like to make might help you choose your materials. I am going to draw a self-portrait inspired by pop art today. For pop art style portrait, you will need a pencil, a pen, a black fine point marker, medium point coloring markers, colored pencils, two sheets of paper, and your printed photo. I'm going to trace my photo. Rub your pencil all over the blank paper. Please make sure fill the blank as much as you can. And then turn the page, place it over your final paper. Put your photo on top of them. Now I am ready to trace. You can also tape these papers if you want. Draw over the line that you want to keep using a pen. You will get the outline of the shapes. There we have it. Then I'll start drawing. Make up lines with a fine point marker. I am putting some shapes on my eyes. You can also put some shades using the markers. If you are all done, let's start coloring. I will use coloring markers to paint my face, lips, and shirts. I love these markers because they can express vivid colors well. Saturated colors usually make portraits more pop art-like. My hair color is actually black, though. I colored my hair purple. I wanted to make my portrait much expressive. I covered the shades with the purple color because I am not satisfied with them. If you make any mistake, no worries at all. You can cover it and try another way like me. For the background, I'll use a pink colored pencil. It is so smooth that I can easily fill the background. You can also use markers, crayons, or acrylic paints as well. After coloring the background, I will add a bold outline, which is a main characteristic of the pop art. If you are all done, you can add more detail to your painting with a fine point marker. For the last parts, I will draw some shades on my hair with black and purple markers. All done! Let's check in with my friends on the education team to see how they approach this prompt.
Hi everyone, it's Chelsea. For this week's prompt of making a portrait, I decided to make a collage using different colored paper, and I decided I was going to make a more expressive collage. So instead of making something that really looks realistic and looks like me, I decided to make a collage using lots of different colors and bold shapes that kind of convey the way I feel or some of the different colors or I don't know, ideas that I have inside me. So I started with really simple shapes. And I really like using collage paper because I can move it around and I don't have to commit to anything right away. So I cut stuff out and I cut them down into smaller pieces, or I move them around to different places, and that really helps me decide where I want things to go without having to know right away. I can kind of experiment as I go along. I have very curly, big curly hair, which I think of as a kind of defining quality of the way that I look. And as you're working on your portrait, it's a good thing to think about sort of the things that make you stand out in the way that you look and focus on those when you do a portrait. And that's an easy way to make it look like you right away. So I started making a lot of different strands of colorful curly hair. And while I was working on this, it made me think that it would be really cool to have rainbow hair like this. I kind of wish that I do. But regardless, I still cut out the pieces in all different colors just to, play with the style that I was working in and convey this curly hair as being sort of one of the main qualities of this person that I'm making, this picture of myself. So I really like how the hair was looking and playing with where I could put the different strands in to add a rainbow hair. Then I added a little nose ring because I have a nose ring and that's also another defining quality of the way I look. And I went to work gluing it down. The portrait changed a little bit between when I started and when I glued it down, which always happens because I don't always remember where I put the paper first. But that's also part of the process, is just kind of figuring it out and experimenting as I go. And I'm really happy with the way it turned out. I think this is a really fun portrait. And even though it doesn't look exactly like me, I think that it looks enough like me. And it definitely conveys a very cool and colorful, sort of abstract concept of a portrait, which I really liked. So I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. I hope you like it too.
Hi, this is Jules. I'm really excited to share with you my page for this week and how I went about doing this prompt. At first, I was pretty nervous because I've never been really good at painting realistic faces or portraits, and it's just not something I'm used to at all. So I was nervous, but I was also excited to see what I could do with this. After looking at all of the examples that we showed this week, I was kind of reminded that your portraits don't have to be realistic and they don't have to look perfectly like a face, and there's so many other ways that you can make a portrait without having to draw or paint really realistically. So what I decided to do was just kind of draw some parts of a face on my piece of paper. I drew one more that looked like an entire face, and then some random eyes, some noses, eyebrows, lips, all over the page, and was just thinking about the different parts of your face. And then I just picked some colors that I thought would look good together and just went about with my paintbrush and just filled in the page. I used a lot of random quick brush strokes. I put the paint on really thick in some places and thin in other places. I kind of just kept going over it until I was happy with all of the colors. I thought that this was really, really fun to make because I wasn't stressed out or thinking that, oh, no one's gonna think that this is a face, no one's gonna know, it's not accurate enough. I really was just thinking about color and brush strokes, and I just am really excited thinking about all of the different ways that you can make art without thinking that you have to make things look perfect and you can really just play and paint abstractly. I definitely want to do this again. I had so much fun making this page and just putting all these random little marks all over it. And I do kind of think that you can see the faces in my painting, but even if you can't, it's okay because it was fun. And that's what making art is all about, is making things that you really enjoy and not thinking about what other people think. So I really hope you like this page and I really hope that you have fun doing this prompt with us. This project lined up perfectly with the things we're doing in my art class this week, actually. I've been working on portraits for about 2 weeks now, so this was fun. I decided to take a different route and really just use bold colors because I love them. I drew a face that is based on a portrait that I have drawn before, and then just use chalk pastel to color it because pastels blend really, really well, and I kind of wanted to get a flow of like bold and contrasting colors. I think the portrait looks pretty like fiery, for lack of a better word, but I like how it turned out a lot. So yeah.
Thank you so much for watching. We can't wait to see what you create. Show us your artwork with the hashtag Palmer Online Art Club. We'll see you next time for another look into the Palmer's collection. Bye!